Hello, everybody, and welcome to round number 11 of the Sunoco Elite Series. We are here at beautiful Sonoma, and we will be doing 25 laps around this very strategic road course. And there's lots of uphills and downhills, and there's some trouble sections that could cause some big incidents. So, on the pole today is Scott Roush, who had an interesting strategy at Portland, but now gets his first pole of the season at Sonoma, maybe looking at his first win, alongside Tyler Avery, who has his best career qualifying. In row two, also Zach Smith ties his best qualifying position in third, alongside Eric Monaco, who has 2 second places on the season. In row three, we have Vance Caldwell, who has been pretty much outclassed by his teammate James Constantin, but Constantin is nowhere near the front today, and we'll have to see, can Caldwell capitalize on that, alongside Laughter Stuhl, who's been improving lately in the points. In row 4 is a row full of Scott Ganassi cars. John Racer in the 32 car got a penalty in Todd Green, but he's been recovering slowly but surely. He is now sitting in the 7th position alongside his team owner, Philip Scott, who won at Portland and Diamond Ridge. And now we'll have to see, can he win here at Sonoma? And in row 5, it's Aiden Shepherd, who won at Todd-Ring, who is looking to maybe get his second career win alongside Max Anderson, who, fun fact, is one of two people who has never led a lap in the Sunoco Elite Series. The other one is Ryan Monaco, who sits near the back of the pack. So, not good for him. Other big threats on the race, Jake Baskinger dominated at Virginia and is now looking for a good finish here to maybe get himself even more points. Sorry about that. Apparently that wasn't aligned correctly. There we go. Sorry about that. That was technical difficulties. But Jake Baskinger is one of the big threats for this race. Nick Pericles, who is sitting pretty high up in position, would be going after a points lead if Eric Monaco doesn't throw this away. If Eric Monaco throws this away, Nick Pericles could definitely be your provisional points leader. Same with William Brock, who sits right behind him. So big threats for this race. It's going to be Tyler Avery. No one's pulling into the pits, meaning we will not recase this start. Unless something goes wrong here. Tyler Avery on the outside. This actually normally happens. Don't worry about it. They'll fix it. We'll see Roush come around the outside. And Avery get a little bit of a jump so that Monaco can slim into line. And we will be going green. Scott Roush is going to lead it to the green flag here at Sonoma International Raceway. International Raceway. Scott Roush, green flag is out for Roush. Nice jump for Zach Smith behind. Zach Smith is actually going to slip into the second position, maybe. Oh! Caldwell has an incident, and now everyone is 3 and 4 wide. This is not going to end well. I can tell you that right now. This is going to end extremely poorly. Oh, this is going to end actually horrifically. There goes Bunnell. Oh, no. Everything's happening now. Oh, God, here comes the trouble section. If they stay side by side, good. They solve it. If you go side by side through here, it's a big risk. Oh, saved it. Anyone gonna go really wide here? That was a chaotic start. To say the least. What happened to Caldwell? So here's Caldwell's bit of fun as he'd get into Laughter Stuhl, and he'd go out into the grass, which would cause a big incident here that if we look up ahead with John Bunnell was the car involved with John Racer. Racer would go wide, come back down, and he
opponent would get clipped by Racer, and around they would go into a tire barrier. And that's their day done. Bad luck for them. But hey, at least it's not a penalty for John Racer. But now... Smith does not want to give up that second position. If he can get a second position, that'll be his best career finish. Same with Avery, though. They're side-by-side coming into the last corner. This isn't really a trouble section, so you can go side-by-side through here. And Zach Smith's gonna get the move done. So Smith takes the second position, and Roush is your early leader. Contact between Avery and Monaco. Monaco doesn't want to risk too much because he is high in points. Speaking of high in points, where is Pericles and Brock? Right here, they're still together. 9th and 10th. What about the other points contenders? Constantin is out! Constantin is out! What happened? This will be your points leader's day over. Well, second in points. Bakula would get into row, an innocent bystander of Constantin. I forgot to mention this. Constantin is now second in points, now behind Fitzwater, who sits 21st. Fitzwater is your points leader, but he sits down in position, which is not good for him because he's got three points contenders ahead of him, especially Eric Monaco. This doesn't look like Avery's done with that position, though. Nope. Avery's not done with Smith. This is a battle. The battle continues. Oh! Around they go! And around would go everybody! They fought too much! Oh, this is chaotic! And that's Torres's day done. Everyone side by side. Into the trouble section as well. Oh, this is not going to go well. You know who this went well for is Zachary Fitzwater. Who is just laughing at their stupidity right now. And, I would be too. That was stupid. Just in one word. Stupid. That was probably the stupidest move we've seen all season long. But it was probably one of the most action-packed. Fitzwater, because of this, moves from 18th to 14th. What happened? Whose fault was this? Savory would be in it. Oh, it would be Smith going wide. Smith did not enter the track safely. And around, they would all go. And then this would be Monaco's day done. That would be Torres's day done. And Fitzwater would be laughing as he would gain so much position through this. Let's go on board with Fitzwater through this craziness of this pack. As Fitzwater would take advantage of all of them and would take it away. What a move by Fitzwater, as that's going to help his points by a lot because now Monaco's behind him. What a beginning to the race! Wow. Whew. And the person who's just running away is Roush. Roush is your leader now. Still. But now it's Phillip Scott who sits second. Max Anderson, who hasn't led a single lap this season, now sits third. I believe this will be his first podium. Pericles sits fifth, and Brock sits sixth. That's still not very good for Fitzwater, because even though these guys, I don't think they take over his points lead, they'd still take a good position! And around would go Pericles! The test races were never like this! That's Pericles' day done. And that's another two positions for Fitzwater. Here's another position for Fitzwater. On Gerard Aron. Fitzy is just laughing. He's gotta be just enjoying this. But Brock now sits fourth. But Team Flames Racing's number 38 car, Roush,
Oh, pit road is actually closed. Huh. There's no cautions. So pit road is closed. Interesting. There may be some oil out on the track as these people are exiting pit road for damage repairs. You are allowed to come in when pit road is closed if there's too much damage on your car. Racer exits pit road correctly. Good. This time. Avery exiting pit road right in the middle of traffic. Heed Clipart! And another wreck! And Art's done. How is he going to get himself out of this? Oh, that's a lot of damage. What a... That's just four laps that we just went through. Four laps. Had all of that craziness. What a start. That is probably the most crazy start I've ever seen in my entire life. Pit road is still closed. Strange. No one's allowed to enter pit road except for damage repairs. This is something I've never seen before as well. That there is so much damage in pit road. There's so many parts and debris in pit road that they actually had to close pit road under green. That's a first for me. I'm not sure about you guys, but that's a first for me. Pit road is closed for the time being, and Roush does not care, may I add. Here's his big pack. Fitzwater 6-12. Like I said, Baskinger is going to be a big threat for this race, and now he sits 13th behind the points leader, Fitzwater. And I don't think he'll be behind him for very long, because he is faster by about 6/10. Maybe Fitzwater's got something stuck in the grill, because he is very slow on the track right now. Any big fast laps, Roush is your fastest car. There's Arndt now coming out of pit road after his incident. Here is Philip Scott, Anderson, Brock, Turbo, Bowers. We're going to see, where does Arndt come out, and does he do the same thing that Avery did? I cannot believe what has happened. Everyone passing by. Everyone got out before Arndt did. Nice job. He hit his teammate! Oh, that is going to be some talk in the garage. Definitely. Between those teammates, Pericles' rear ends aren't. There's going to be some garage talk about that. And I think the start has finally calmed down. Yeah, we've calmed down. And here's your order as of now. Oh, it may not have calmed down. Here's Collins. More CJ troubles, maybe. Oh, pushes Benoit wide, but doesn't go too far. Okay. Kyle Collins looking on the inside of Benoit and Ravine. Pit road is still closed? Really? But because it's damage repairs, Pericles is allowed to come down. He is allowed. That's the only situation in which you are allowed to come down pit road, is under damage repairs. And Pericles, got hit by his teammate. There's definitely going to be some talk in the garage about that one. Bowers, not a bad position, 6-6th right now. He's also a point threat. He's around 11th, 12th in points. If he can get something good here, he could possibly move himself in probably the top 7 somewhere in there. As for everyone else here, no one else he really has a big threat up in points. Except for Fitzwater, who is dropping like a rock. I think there's something stuck in Fitzwater's grill. Fitzwater is really slow right now. Here's Collins. Yeah, there's definitely something wrong with Fitzwater's car. There's something in that grill. Maybe there's an overheating problem. Pit road's still closed, though, so Fitzwater cannot come down because it technically is not a damage repair. Fitzwater just praying for pit road to open. As now we're getting reports that there may be a light malfunction, actually, at the start of pit road. So, actually, pit road is not closed. Pit road is actually open right now. Nobody knows that, as now their teams are actually broadcasting that out to everyone, that the light on pit road entry is malfunctioning. Let's hope they get that fixed before the end of the race, but pit road is open. Yeah, that light is definitely having some problems. Is anyone going to take this opportunity now? Will Fitzwater take this opportunity now that he knows that pit road is open? Will he come in or will he just stay out and stretch it until pit cycle? But a 1:15 is not good. But he's going to stay out again. I think he's going to try to stretch it to pit stops. Not a very good idea. Max Anderson! Right on the back of Philip Scott now. I think Roush is going to win this race. After that crazy start, now I think Roush has got this. A lot of people falling out of the race now. But we are actually not live right now. We'll go live. Just a moment. Here we are. We are live now. Catch you up on some things. There at the bottom of the list is everyone who's dropped out. Nobody new has dropped out, though. No one knew. So nothing has really happened except for Zach Smith coming out of the pits. All of his damage has been repaired. He spent a lot of time on pit road damaging that. It actually cost him an entire lap, but his car is back on pace, and they say that his car should be working perfect now. If not perfect, they don't know what's wrong with it now. Maybe engine damage. But they do say his car is working perfectly now. Yep, they got that light fix. They do have that light fix now. So, where is Fitzwater? 15th. Dropping like a rock. He needs to come down pit road now and see what's wrong with that grill. Because Fitzwater's reporting an overheating problem in that car a little bit, so they're trying to pull down the car. We're not sure if he still has some debris on the car, as the broadcast cannot pick up radio communication, sadly, so we cannot show you that radio communication, but earlier, when he was pulling 115s, they did report an overheating problem in that car. I may have settled down now. Not sure. But Roush, 6.5 seconds, almost, is the gap between him all the way back to Philip Scott and Max Anderson. Whew, what a start. I know this is like the fifth time I've said it. But what a start. So much action. Just what a start. Here is your Toyota moment of the race, as this is going to be a new thing in the series, the Toyota moment of the race, as Zach Smith would run wide and wreck second, third, and fourth, pretty much out of winning contention. That's your moment of the race right there, definitely. Tyler Avery, Zach Smith, and Eric Monaco will get turned. There will be more action there as Torres will get pushed into a wall by Bowers. All this chaos on lap two. That was your Toyota moment of the race. But back up at the front, lap 14, the gap is 6.6 seconds. As they finally got that light repaired. Ew. Now that light's repaired, now Fitzwater knows for sure that pit road's open. Why has he not come down yet? Actually, we do have reports that Fitzwater was able to get that off. Nope, now he's going in. He still feels something wrong with the car, but he did get the debris off of his grill. But Fitzwater still feels that there's a problem in the car, so bad luck for Fitzwater after that lap 2 incident, getting all that position and then losing it once again. Tough break for Zachary Fitzwater. There's actually a few more people coming down pit road as we speak. Ryan Monaco and Vince Caldwell are here as well. But Roush is running with us now. Turbo, Roush's teammate, in fifth. So there's two Team Flame cars in the top five, as they really need this, because actually, fun fact, Team Flame Racing is tied in points with Red Stallion Racing, but their best car seems to be behind all of their cars. So what a break for Team Flame Racing, as they have all their cars in the top. Really? They have them all the way up in the top seven. Everyone's in now. Roush is in. Anyone going to do that stretch? Vincent, lap car. Racer, lap car. Dodd? Nope. It'll be the entire lead pack. So now, Roush. He can relax, get four tires, get fuel, and he can come out ahead because he had a 7-second gap coming in. He could pump it full of fuel and he can make it to the end. Easy. Oh! Phillips got actually gained substantial amount. Wow! That was like 3 or 4 seconds gained there. Did he only take two tires? Maybe. Oh, Brock jumps Anderson. That's interesting. So everyone's coming out of pit road now. Collins! Nice, 11th. Now on track. Oh, Shepard was 4th. That sucks. But, oh god, here's all the way through this pack. Here is Fitzwater now, 19th, as actually it was an early pit for Fitzwater, as they are reporting that that car seems to be working fine now, as during that first wreck, apparently a piece of Zach Smith's car got into Fitzwater's grill. I don't know how that happened. Maybe it just flew between the cars right into Fitzwater's grill, but we do have reports that it was a piece of Zach Smith's car after that wreck. But they did get it off with the back of Benoit Laravine's car a few laps before pits. And now Fitzwater is just working to gain the salvage position that he lost before. People in the pits now. Alright, who's the fastest car on the track now? Oh, Brock's pretty fast. But that's because he had an earlier pit stall, so it didn't pass the finish line time. William Brock. Can Brock get past Philip Scott? He's pretty fast now because he's caught right up to the back of Philip Scott, who has already won 2 races on this season. And to get a 3rd race would be absolutely incredible, and it would be a 2nd in a row if he can get this done. But it's a long road ahead to Scott Roush. That's still 2.5 seconds. But they gained a good 5 seconds on Roush at last time, that pit cycle. Max Anderson now battling with Tommy Turbo. As may I add, that Fitzwater All-Star Racing has Anderson now 5th, Karenko 6th, Bauer 7th, and then it's all the way back to Fitzwater 19th. That's a pretty good performance out of that team. But one team that's not having a good day, Epic Motorsports. James Constant didn't have a good day. Gakula didn't have a good day. Dan Serber's actually having a decent day and sitting down in the 21st position. So not too bad for him. and their last member, Vance Caldwell, sits 18th. John Racer! Getting out of the pits. No, there may be a problem with that car. Oh, there was a crash. What happened? Oh, Racer! Racer would whip that car around. He would hit a pole and whip around and just collect Finn Guy. Stewards are talking, but they're pretty sure it's not going to be a penalty. I'm not exactly sure about that. This will help Fitzwater get another position. Pretty much just salvaging now. But like I said, Scott Roush running away. Or not. Philip Scott is faster than him, but this pace, 4/10 a lap. He'll catch. He'll catch at 4/10 a lap. If he's able to keep this pace up. Pit Road is back closed. They have that way, and we do have confirmation that Pit Road is actually closed. Except for the obvious damage repairs. They're allowed to come down Pit Road for damage repairs. But that is it. No, just tires and fuel. So, we don't know why Pit Road is closed this time. Why is Pit Road closed? No one else is retired. That's weird. How they just close Pit Road like that? Pit Road is back open, though. There's Tyler Avery, who started second. Oh, there's Finn. It might have been for Finn Guy. Not sure about that, but it might have been for the Finn Guy racer and symbol, which would be weird. There may have been some debris on Pit Road from towing him back. Or they weren't towed back, they went to Pit Road themselves. That's weird. Oh well. As it's 2.2 seconds in 6 laps, I'm not sure if they can pull it. If they can, that'll be an intense race to the finish. But they have to get some intense good laps on Roush to be able to pull this away. Fast lap on the track out of everyone has been Walla there being the Frenchman who just pulled that lap, by the way. And interesting. So Benoit Verveen, the Frenchman, is on a pretty fast lap. He's for Trailblazer. Trailblazer's not having too bad of a day. At least not as bad as Epic Motorsports is. Actually, I think that gap is shortened more now. I think Philip Scott is faster again. See at the line. 113-1. 112-6! Whoa! That was 4/10 of a second. They caught 4/10 of a second again. I believe all three of these guys have at least one podium under their name. Turbo has one. Anderson does not. He has a few, but I believe he has two top fives under his name instead. Not sure if he does have a podium or not. Yeah, they're catching Roush. This race may not be over. Can Philip Scott get his second, his third win on the season? He's catching. I think he's catching more. He's much smoother than Roush is, as it seems. Can he pull this win off? But only a few more laps to go. He caught more. He caught more. That was probably another 4/10. Could this race be heating up again? 113-1. He gains it again! That was 5/10 of a second! And Philip Scott is kicking it into overdrive! As it is a 112-6 versus a 113-1. Roush is probably getting some pressure now. He's probably feeling it now. Philip Scott's starting to breathe down his neck. The gap now, 1.2 seconds. And we're coming to, I believe, 3 to go. And he's gained more. He's gained even more. He goes really wide there, which actually is helping him. Because he has more momentum, as it seems, through this section. Now Roush on the back of Avery. He could use Avery to get a little bit of a gap by using the lap car to his advantage to hold him up. Big question is, how much will actually hold him up? 113.2, 112.8, still gaining. The gap now is 9/10 of a second between your leader, Scott Roush, and second place, Philip Scott, and we're 3 to go. But now Philip Scott's being held up by the lap car of Avery. How long will Tyler Avery... Avery, hold him up. There's Philip Scott. Philip Scott's done with the lap car. This is a really risky section to make this move, but if I was Philip Scott, I'd do the same, because he has no time. He has to take a risk, and it works. It worked. Next lap car up to stop him. No one really. Gerard Aron, maybe. We're coming to 2 laps to go, and the gap is small. Anyone else on pit road for accidents? No. This is it. 2 laps to go for Scott Roush. Can Roush pull it off? Brock wasting no time. He's trying to get his way up as well. 113.0. 113.1. That was because of the lap car of Avery. They also may have problems with Gerard Aron, but it's unlikely. This is it. It's 1 second the gap. Any mistake out of Roush will catch Philip Scott right up to the back. Here we are. We're about to come to 1 lap to go. And Roush has Philip Scott breathing down his neck. He is there. Like I said, any mistake out of Roush will cause Philip Scott to pretty much get this race under his belt. Another win under his belt. Can Philip Scott get it done? Or will this be all Roush coming to the white flag? And he is there. He is right on the back. White flag for Scott Roush. Can he get his first win of the season? Or will it be his... or will be Philip Scott's third? Roush makes a tiny mistake there. That closes Philip Scott. The gap was 5/10 last time around. Any single mistake, even the tiniest of mistakes, is going to cause Philip Scott to make that pass. Roush has got to be perfect now if he wants to win this thing. There's Philip Scott! He's right there! Philip Scott's got to kick it in a little bit more to win this race, though. Philip Scott is making a valiant effort. Philip Scott gets a tighter line. Coming into the carousel for the final time. It's not going to be enough for Philip Scott. Philip Scott tried. He really did. He dug deep and he shortened that gap. But it's not enough. And Scott Roush is going to win his first race in the Sunoco Elite Series. What an effort by Philip Scott. As he was 5/10 of a second too short. William Brock's gonna come away third. PJ Carranco comes away fourth. Carson Bowers comes away fifth. Deon Scott comes away sixth. Paul Jackson seventh. Then Bava Bear being eighth. Jake Baskier ninth. And Lorenzo Log 10th. What a finish. Where did Fitzwater end up? 14th. He made up position. One more time, let's go look at that moment of the race. Because we have to go look at the Toyota moment of the race one more time. Once again, here's the Toyota moment of the race between these three battling. It's Smith, Avery, and Monaco. As Smith would go wide, clip both of them, and they'd both go into the grass, giving up the second, third, and fourth positions, giving them to Philip Scott and Max Anderson. Oh, wow. What an effort. Let's go look at your finishing results. So it's Scott Roush, your winner for Team Flame Racing, getting the third win for Team Flame Racing. It was Tommy Turbo. Well, it was Vincent and then Tommy Turbo, and now Scott Roush gets a win under his belt. Philip Scott second, that's his third podium of the season. Or fourth podium of the season, maybe. What an impressive performance out of Philip Scott. William Brock third. Nice points haul for William Brock. Karanko fourth. Nice finish for Karanko. Bowers, Dion Scott, Paul Jackson, Benoit Theravine, Jake Baskier, Lorenzo Lug, Aiden, and rest of the field there. Fitzwater, I'm not sure if he's going to hold on to his points lead. With William Brock having third and Philip Scott having second, we're not sure about that. But, what a race. That was definitely, one of my favorite rounds of the season. I can tell you that right now. Oh, but, yeah. Next time, round 12 out of 21. As I just want to give you guys a heads up, there will be a video coming out relatively soon about how Mid-Ohio is going to work. And it's going to be a little different than what you guys expect. But until then, guys, I will see you then. Ciao.